அப்புறம் தேர்ட் டாபிக் லிம்போமா பை டாக்டர் சுமன் கல்யாண். Okay, now we go to the next topic, and then fatty liver by Dr. Jha Varghese.
This is sir, camera is record.
Yes. I was in the Global Hospital as a liver transplant physician. I completed MBBS MD from the Madurai and a DM from Stanley Hospital. Then the transplant fellowship from Germany. In the last 8 years, more than 800 liver transplant I was been associated. Now I am the main Apollo, so program coordinator for transplant. So even though, so I mean, it's a, I have to thank to the organizers, IMD Kodavakam, the secretary, and this is all the kind invitation. So now I'm going to talk about the basic simple diseases, the fatty liver. Next slide, please. Next. So the fatty liver, suppose during my graduation time, MBBS, even my clinical practice, that time even the fatty liver comes, we won't give much importance to the fatty liver. You will say it's normal, okay, go ahead, carry on. But nowadays, just I make alarm of that, then I can go there. After the 800 liver transplantation, so only 60% is due to the organ liver disease related, 30% due to the non-organic fatty liver related liver cirrhosis, only the 10% comes under the hepatitis B virus, C virus, Wilson disease, hemochromatosis, autoimmune. So the fatty liver causing the liver cirrhosis is epidemic in our population, not only in our population, all over the world. In US, it was considered hepatitis C and alpha is the number one. Now, in US also, the fatty liver disease related, the cirrhosis is now changing and its trend is changing and it is causing the first, we're going to the place, the first is for the liver transplant. So, we know the fatty liver disease, the name was coined in the by Ludwig, because that time, just he examined the liver biopsy of non-alcoholic people and he noticed what are the changes will happen in alcoholic individual. Same similar histological finding he identified. So if you're taking the biopsy of the alcohol and non-alcohol, he noticed and he coined the non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. It happened in much earlier, 1980. That time we don't know exactly the pathophysiology and its complication. Now we know very well what is the pathophysiology of the alcohol causing the liver cirrhosis and the non-alcohol, the fatty liver causing the liver cirrhosis. Not only liver cirrhosis, it is also causing the liver cancer. That cycle, everything now well demonstrated. So fatty liver is it is the spectrum of the disease. So spectrum of the disease means there are some things are good, some things not good. So if you see, first it starts with the simple fatty, the steatosis of the liver. Suppose you are doing biopsy, it will show only the fat droplet. If you see the hepatocytes, either one third of the hepatocyte or more than one third of the hepatocyte occupied by the fat droplets. It is called the simple fatty liver. Steatohepatitis means here there is the inflammation, not only the fat droplets, we can see polymorph ulcerous lymphocyte infiltration surrounding the hepatocyte, particularly portal triad. So next we go. The third is the, whenever there is an inflammation over the period of time, the healing process will start. That time it will form the scar formation, that is called fibrosis. So if the fibrosis is keep on increasing, we have to think about liver is the regenerative capacity. whatever the dead cell happened, the adjacent normal cell will start to reactivate, it will overdo. So that is called regenerative hyperplasia, the nodule formation. So we can see the dead cell, at the same time we can see the nodule, hypernodule overfunction level. That is called cirrhosis. And whatever the etiology of the cirrhosis, if you do the alcohol related or B virus or C virus or metabolic related liver cirrhosis or non-alcoholic, the fatty liver related liver cirrhosis, there is a 4 to 8% of the people, the cirrhotic cell is a pre-malignant. What are the pre-malignant, if you are telling the leukoplakia, etc. The similarly, any form of the cirrhosis, the pre-malignant, there is a chances to go for the liver cancer. So this is the schematic diagram. So first simple steatosis, normally liver will be the pink color, in steatosis it will be the yellowish color. Whenever we are doing the transplant also, whenever we are opening, even the surgeon, just with simple vision itself, they say the liver is the fatty liver, it's not a good liver. And then it go for the inflammation. This is the histological finding. NASH is the not the clinical finding. And then this one is the cirrhosis. So what about the prevalence? So I already made a comment about it is the not only in India or Tamil Nadu, worldwide the fatty liver causing the liver cirrhosis and the liver disease is increasing the day by day. The China, Japan, South Korea, Sri Lanka, if you see 33%. So almost 1/3 of the population will have the fatty liver in Sri Lanka. And Indonesia, if you come to the India, there is a various, so in north, south, there are different places, the various study codes around 9% to 35%. So this also alarming. So the why the prevalence is comes more, it is mostly due to the our diet habit and our the less physical activity. So what are the risk factors? Why I am getting fatty liver? Why the fatty liver disease is more common in our country? So we can divide it into the primary and the secondary. We can concentrate only on the primary. So the primary, if you see, there are the three main things. One is the type 1 diabetes and the genetic and the obesity. So this will, the other, all are the small things actually. So this is very common in our population. We know Asians are more prone to get diabetes. So automatically, we are more prone to get fatty liver than the genetic factor and obesity. So if we are seeing this, the diagrammatic, suppose if we are taking the 100 people of the fatty liver, so the diabetes comes around sometimes only 15%. Some of the people will have a cholelithiasis, obesity, but the very important is the insulin resistant. So if the insulin resistant is the main pathophysiology of the causing the fatty liver. Nowadays, even in we can check the insulin resistant in our patient simply by sending the blood sample. So whenever the insulin resistant comes positive, even though they are not diabetic, it might be the pre-diabetic, and that group is more prone to get the fatty liver. So what other causes? So I told type 1 diabetes, but not only type 1, type 2 also, and obesity main way. Other causes of the fatty liver, Wilson disease, it is not very common. Then the metabolic disorder, this is common in children, and the hepatitis C virus. So this also due to the new drug availability, almost in the eradication phase, and the drugs, some of the drugs will cause the fatty liver like steroid, tamoxifen, amiodarone, methotrexate, diltiazem, and the TPN and something the starvation. So even the starvation also will cause the fatty liver, even though they are cachectic, but the liver while doing the ultrasonogram, you will show the pathophysiology is different in the starvation causing the fatty liver. And some of the obesity related surgery, because of the obesity, we are doing some kind of the surgery, bariatric surgery, but the nutritional supplement is very, very important, the reduction of the nutrition. If something is irregular, we can see, even though they will lose the body weight, but at the same time, the liver will go for fatty liver. That is called the obesity surgery related acute or subacute liver failure with the dead patient also, they need liver transplant. So what is the natural history? So it is a very, very slowly progressing liver disease. It is, if we are seeing the fatty liver, then 10% of the individual over the 10 years of period, it will go showing the NASH. And if the inflammation, biopsy proven in the inflammation, the liver disease, 10% of the people over the 10 years are going cirrhosis. So if you are seeing this picture, even though the prevalence is more in our country, 9% to 33%, so no need to get panic, all the people will get the liver cirrhosis. That fatty liver, 90% of the individuals, still they can stay with a simple fatty liver. Only 10% of the people will get the NASH. Even they are getting the biopsy proven NASH, only the next 10% or so, overall if you look into that, either getting the cirrhosis, even 1/3 of the population we have, it will be taking around the 20 years time, almost come less than 2%. So even the 2% in our population, it is very huge, and there is a possibility to get the hepatocellular carcinoma. So the fatty liver, we can divide into the mild, whenever doing this all biopsy proven, not ultrasonograph based, like grade 1, grade 2, it is totally observer variation will be there. Biopsy wise, if we are doing the liver biopsy, in the general, the low power, not the high power, the low power, if you are seeing the number of hepatocytes, approximately 1/3 of the hepatocytes are looks fat droplets, means that is called mild. If that field 30 to 60% of the 50% approximately looks the fat droplets, means the moderate. In the field, microscopy field, we are seeing more than 60% of everywhere it is the fat droplets within the hepatocyte, means it is called severe fatty liver. Then this is the differentiating, I said this is a spectrum of the disease, simple fatty liver, inflammation due to the fatty liver, that is called NASH, and cirrhosis. If you see, ultrasonograph will show simple fatty liver. Even if you are doing biopsy, we can see the only fat droplets, no inflammatory cells like a polymorph lymphocyte. In this, the blood test, SGPT or the ALT will be normal. And it is totally reversible. That is a good thing. Reversible means, due to that, the diet modification, lifestyle modification, fatty liver will go to the, will revert back to the normal liver. So second stage, 10 years period of the time, 10% will go to the NASH. That time, SGPT will show abnormal. Abnormal means don't think SGPT will jump like acute viral hepatitis many fold. Just if the upper limit is 50, 35 to 50 or something H level, you will go to the double the time. Instead of 50, it will show 70 or 100 or 110. So whenever the SGPT or ALT shows above 100 or 35 is their upper limit, with above 70, double the level of the upper limit of the normal. So that's called NASH. That group, if you are doing the biopsy, it will show inflammation. Because of the inflammatory cell infiltration, there is a rise in the SGPT. Fortunately, this is also completely reversible by the diet modification, lifestyle, and here some of the medications also will play a role. I will come into the subsequent slide. If we are ignoring this state, if you are ignoring this state, they will go to this state. If you are still ignoring, our patients also not giving the more important, the stage will go to cirrhosis. This is the common in our countries, the ladies particularly, and also the teetotaler gents, they are coming as with the cirrhosis. If you ask, I am totally teetotaler, high, I got that liver cirrhosis, everything. Even we are ruling out the all the etiology. If you go through the previous, the 1 year or 5 years before ultrasonogram, always it show the fatty liver. So this is irreversible. So here, yeah, we all know, once cirrhosis comes, we won't give much importance to the enzymes, but we'll give important only to the serum albumin and the INR. So that will be indicates the synthetic function. And if you are doing biopsy, here we can see the fibrosis, we can see the regenerative nodule, and it is irreversible. So the NAFLD nowadays, it's a metabolic component of metabolic syndrome. Metabolic syndrome, usually the cardiologist the next speaker will be Dr. Gopal Gurin. He knows the cardiologist will talk metabolic syndrome. It is obesity, hypertension, and the hyperglycemia. Now, the fatty liver also come into the part of the metabolic syndrome. So, how we are diagnosing metabolic syndrome? Whenever the BMI is more than 30 and there is a hypertension, hypertriglyceridemia, low HDL and diabetes. So whenever the patient have the combination of the hypertension, diabetes, this our duty here to go through that, asking them to do the ultrasonogram abdomen. If fatty liver comes, we have to routine thing, the lifestyle advice, and we have to serially check it whether the reversibility is there or not. So insulin resistance syndrome, that is the main pathophysiology of the things. If you see the insulin resistance syndrome plays the most of the metabolic syndrome the components, the pathophysiologic factor. So it's called macro. Not only these are the just for the highlighting the important, some of the drugs will cause the macro. Here I am mentioning the alcohol. We know alcohol also will cause the fatty liver. If you see the how alcohol causing the liver cirrhosis, first they will get the alcoholic fatty liver, then the fat droplets will cause the inflammation, fibrosis, cirrhosis. But and this also will cause for liver cancer. But to the step at the level of fatty liver, if the non-alcoholic and alcoholic will differ, once the inflammation starts, both the end alcoholic or non-alcoholic fatty liver, once starts the NASH, it will use the common pathway to progress to cirrhosis and the liver cancer. So these are the other rare causes of the micro as well as the microvesicular steatosis. So pathogenesis is called two-hit hypothesis. So whenever the hepatic accumulation, that means within the liver cells, the fatty, free fatty acid gets accumulation, it will affect the mitochondria of the hepatocyte. We know in whatever the hepatocyte or whatever the cell, mitochondria is the important role, is the respiratory function, the chain. It's this free fatty acid within the hepatocytes, it will affect the mitochondria. Okay. So normally free fatty acid, oxidation, everything happen in the mitochondria. As because of the accumulation of the fat droplets, the mitochondria will lose its the function. So that fatty, the oxidation is defective, will cause the number of free radical release. So the, whenever the free radicals release, so that related the release of all the cytokine, other mediator, inflammatory markers increasing, that will cause the fibrosis. So here I will see, here we have to give the importance of the de novo lipogenesis. So even though the rise in the free fatty acid due to the excessive dietary lipid and the adipose tissue due to the obesity, it will increase in the free fatty acid and the triglyceride and the steatosis, that is a fatty liver. But if you see this hyperglycemia, whenever even we are not taking the excessive the dietary lipids, even though we are not obese, we are thin individual, but if you keep on taking more hyperglycemic, that's why nowadays the trend is the advising less carbohydrate diet. If the hyperglycemia, this hyperglycemia per se increases the de novo lipogenesis. So no need to be a obesity, no need to take always the high lipid diet. Even a thin individual, if you are taking more hyperglycemic cause de novo, that will lead to the free fatty acid formation and the steatosis. So, and these are the completion sake. I will go to the final important. This is the, this electron microscopy study, just to show, I mean, to engage the interest. These are the sinusoid. We know the liver cell, there are sinusoid. Through the sinusoids only blood is going. Adjacent hepatocytes are getting oxygen and nutrient. Whatever the blood goes through the sinusoid, the hepatocytes are getting. These all are adjacent hepatocytes. It is a normal picture. If you see the fat droplets, it is the fatty liver. This is it is a two-dimensional. If you imagine as a three-dimensional, that sinusoid is, it's blocking the sinusoid. It is causing the narrowing of the sinusoid. whenever the sinusoidal alteration comes, the adjacent hepatocyte, it won't get adequate oxygen, it won't get adequate nutrition. Slowly it will go for the ischemia, fibrosis, and the inflammation and cirrhosis. This all the one more slide, and I will go to the important slide. So, what is the treatment for that we have to give? So, hyperglycemia, so we have to correct and we have to convert to the euglycemia, number one, that is very, very important. Regular exercise, because we all have the adequate calorie to lead a normal life. Whenever our diet is more than the adequate calorie per day, based on our activity, if you are taking more calorie, we have to burn it out. Otherwise, the extra calorie will convert into the fat droplets. So, the regular exercise is important. And whatever we are day-to-day practice using the ursodeoxycholic acid or vitamin E or isolintide and pentoxifilin, if you ask the RCT trial-wise, this all still not proven. But only nowadays the vitamin E, the EVON, whatever the formula available, the vitamin E supplementation, particularly 400 milligram twice a day, they have proven reducing the inflammation. That also applicable only in non-diabetic individual. If a non-diabetic individual, those who have obesity and they have the severe fatty liver, altered LFT is there, that time it will help. So, in summary, NAFLD is the non-alcoholic fatty liver is very common, and it is the hepatic manifestation of the metabolic syndrome, and the diet, that means a less carbohydrate diet, and the lifestyle modification, that means the regular activity. Usually the recommended is the just 30 minutes walk means 7 days, 45 minutes walk means 5 days in a week. So even Saturday, Sunday, we don't need to walk, but we have to walk every day, 5 days means 45 minutes. That is the well-made recommendation. And the, sometimes it's a genetic related also. And the simple fatty liver under the NASH is completely reversible. But if it goes to the cirrhosis stage, it is irreversible. And the de novo lipolysynthesis, reduced the free fatty oxidation, this all causing the fibrosis and the cirrhosis. And the adipose tissue, the releasing adipokine also important. And the recommended drug at present, it is the vitamin E, only those who doesn't have a diabetic. Diabetic people, the anti-diabetic medication is very important, keeping the euglycemic level. Obesity patients, we have to reduce the body weight. If we are sure doing that, then regular weight loss, that is 7 to 9% of the weight loss, has proven the liver histology-based improvement. That's why its a reversibility is possible. Thank you. Thank you so much for this.
Excuse me, can you tell me what is the paleo diet and how does it?
So paleo diet, sir, if you go through that, mostly we have less carbohydrate diet, paleo diet. So the paleo diet mostly concentrating on the protein diet. So the protein is good, but that's why the paleo diet also is helping for the fatty liver. Usually I will learn.
Questions?
See, there is no particular treatment for fatty liver.
Only the lifestyle modification, simple. That's a very good message.
Whatever we tell the diabetic patient, we tell him the same thing. Because 99% of the ultrasound in the diabetic shows fatty liver. And all of us advise on the diabetic and pain management and exercise and so on. So the diagnosis of fatty liver is only an index to say 10% of them may develop later some problem. But as of now, I think fatty liver, there is no particular way to say this person will develop a cancer later.
That is only the end state. Whenever the fatty liver we are doing the ultrasonogram, we have to look into the particularly SGPT or ALT, not the SGOT or other parameter in LFT. Whenever the SGPT is goes double the time of the upper limit of the normal, that time it is called ongoing inflammation. That group is very important. We have to advise them seriously. We have to bring down the SGPT in the serial. After 1 month, we have to tell to come for review whether their lifestyle modification wise they are improving or not. If the persistent SGPTs keep on increasing, even whatever the lifestyle modification they are doing, that individuals are more prone to get these cirrhosis.
Yeah, are there any biomarkers for this fibrosis, early fibrosis?
Yes, sir. Actually I skipped the slides. Biomarkers are there, blood test wise, fibro test, etc. But simple test is the, nowadays available is the fibro scan. So fibro scan is the indirect evidence. Without doing liver biopsy, we can say the fibrosis in the liver.
Right, and that's fibro scan is completely
non-invasive.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. Srinath of JV Hospital. Sir, please come and give a certificate appreciation to Dr. Jayavathis.